Here in this community. We lived for the river because it's our food resource. And I feel like it relates to the school because the school's a sacred place.
Well, we try really hard to create what we call place-based education. So that way we're using our local area and our students' local knowledge of our area as a springboard, as a starting point, as a place of excitement to spark our education and to make it more relevant and more meaningful. We live in one of the most beautiful places in the world, and so it's really much more fun to be able to go out and learn in the real world. And so instead of just studying in a textbook in our classroom, to go out and learn from people who live in our area, to learn by doing and getting our hands dirty and our feet wet.
I've been involved with YTEP, which is the Yurok Tribal Environmental Program, and I worked 6 weeks with the Yurok Tribal Fisheries. We would go out and check fish traps or learn more about the problems in the Klamath River and how we can fix them. Klamath River is very centered. It's been part of our native culture for thousands of years. It's kept us grounded and intact with our cultural roots.
Native art's pretty big around the community. Like, one of our students, Raven, her mother came in to teach basket weaving last year. And so that was really fun. She taught us how to make medicine baskets, and she was starting to teach us how to make baby baskets. So that was awesome.
For me, learning Yurok language here is important to me because we don't have very many language speakers left. When your own language is dying, you know, if your language dies and part of your culture dies, and it's important for us as a school and as a community to keep the culture alive.
We get to get out and really learn about the history of the role of the river in our people and our area, and then the future, the current efforts that our people are using to protect and preserve our natural resources here on the river, and then the future of the river and how all of us can be involved in that, whether we're artists or we're biologists or we're fisher people or we're politicians, that we all have a role to play in helping protect and preserve our river.
River cleanup's important because there's a lot of pollution and trash that goes into the river that was never was there before. Our people never disrespected the river like we do today. And the Klamath River cleanup is really taking action and bringing back our culture. And that's important because as Indian people, we rely on our culture and our language and our dances and our food resource.
Thank you. the river and culture and the school is a very delicate thing. And the river is such a bad shape. I've been fighting for it since I was 12 years old, and I see it's going downhill, and I'm still fighting for the dam to come out. And the school has to get structure and move on with everything that's happening because the dam's coming out. And it's such an opportunity for the kids, for biologists and working with the dams coming out, and it's going to be probably a lifetime job.
Well, life is something pretty precious. If you do it right, everybody around you will accomplish something. Do whatever you can to help people out, to make their life more better. It's good.
I think it's helped our kids a lot to be at the school. I think they're more outgoing, they speak better, they talk to you, and where a lot of kids just hang their heads and say hi and walk on past, it's a very good school, and it's people that care about what's happening to your kids. It's people that love your kids, you know.
My favorite thing about the school is being supported and all around being pushed in the right direction and someone always being there for you.
The school here, like, I wouldn't really call it a school, I'd call it more of a support group. You come to school to learn, but if things get hard, you're not alone on this. I mean, everyone's here to back you up. And you got teachers who are kind of like older family that directs you in ways that keep you from getting in trouble. And if you get in trouble, they don't really punish you. They kind of teach you on what you can do next time to keep yourself out of trouble. And the students are kind of like cousins or family. Even when you got drama, I mean, it only lasts for a little bit of time, 1-2 days at the most, and then everything's over again and you're back on the court. You know, things cool here.
My favorite thing about this school would have to be the fact that everybody's so close-knit, you know? Like Missy said, we are like a family, and the thing is that I really like the school is that if need be, we get one-on-one time with the teachers. Like, say if we're having trouble with math or English, we can sit down with the math or English teacher and they will help us with what we need help on.
In 5 years, I see this school in a beautiful, wonderful building, something that everyone can be proud of, that everyone can feel good about, and that elders and community members and students can all feel like very comfortable and very safe and inspired in a physical place at our school.
What life in this community kind of flows like the river. Sometimes it flows fast and everybody's on track, and sometimes it slows down and it stops and things start to kind of go downhill and kind of be drained away from what's really important in life. But with a little bit of help and when we can all get together, it can be restored and replenished and it can flow again like it's supposed to.